Early this year, Parliament passed a resolution urging government to allow local governments to spend at source part of local revenues collected by local governments. To date, the Minister of Finance has been elusive to implement the resolution until today, when the Minister of State for Planning, Amos Logolovi, told off Parliament that they have been constrained to implement the resolution due to its legal implications.
I did mention that there are implications. And because of those implications, we are constrained. And I indicated the three implications. Okay. And one of them indicated there are legal issues. You may need to amend the law.
No, that is captured. You have put it on record.
So in view of that, it is difficult for us to proceed on this matter.
The minister faulted Parliament for passing such a resolution without enough information on its implications, but also made a point that by spending at source local revenue, governments can abuse these funds. However, this did not go well with some legislators.
No, Parliament urging the government to reverse the directive requiring local governments to remit all local revenues to the consolidated fund may have been reached based on incomplete information or based on the local government revenue business process.
Keep it to that. I know both the ministers who are here. They are fairly modest people. And that's where their stubbornness begins. See, this parliament now wants to believe that actually the reason they are doing so because their hands are tied because of the law. And I see everybody believing.
Legislators also opened the Constitution and the Public Finance Management Act of 2015 and pointed out provisions that allow local governments to collect local revenue and spend part of it at source. They accused Cabinet for bulldozing Parliament by frustrating its resolutions.
OB was making reference to the Public Finance Management Act. Right on, Speaker, I think we need to set the record straight. If the reason for not implementing the resolution of Parliament is with the Public Finance Management Act, then we must be very clear about it.
Of the Local Government Act, not disempower local government. We allowed local government to continue collecting money. Even as we speak today, local government collect money in terms of procurement on behalf of URA. If you are procuring service from URA, from local government, maybe to build a school, you pay tax. That tax goes to the account of local government. Local government transmits to URA.
The House is concerned that by requiring the local governments to remit all revenues to the consolidated fund affects service delivery, which they can't bear with anymore.
The role of decentralization is to empower the lower units to live to the aspiration of their voters, and that they be a true reflection of what we are at national level, so that they can account to their people, reduce the burden from us, so that we don't become the center of all burden.
If you are constrained from implementing, address the concerns and show the member that we are going to address these concerns properly. Whereby the main concern on that motion was that local governments collect extra revenues. You don't allow them to utilize these extra revenues. When you allow, it comes in form of supplementaries that come in May.
The problem, some local governments were understating the budgets for local revenue. And once this happens and they collect more, in order for them to access this excess local revenue, they require a budget. And the supplementary budget has been coming.
The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, gave the Minister of Finance only a week to consult the Attorney General and report back to Parliament on the actions taken.
The money, by the time they receive the money, the financial is ending. Money goes back to the consolidated fund and they are constrained. So those were the issues. I can see you have tried to touch them, but we can be explicit.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.